Welcome to the Fit Small Business Xero training course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to accept online payments from customers in Xero. To follow along with me, log into your Xero account now or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. You can also click this link to access our full Xero course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. As we discussed in the Accounts Receivable Aging Report lesson, it's very important to stay on top of the money that your customers owe you, known as accounts receivable balance. By giving your customers the option to make payments online, you will get paid much faster. This saves you time you would normally have to spend chasing after customer payments, and it helps mitigate cash flow issues resulting from payment delays. In this lesson, we will show you how to connect a payment service to Xero so that your customers can make payments online directly from their invoices. Please note, if you have customers who live in another country, you can even accept payment in a foreign currency. Be sure to watch our How to Set Up Multi-Currency video tutorial for step-by-step instructions. You can click here to access this lesson. The first step to accepting online payments from your customers is to connect a payment service to Xero. Using our fictitious company, Acme Web Pros Plus, we will show you how to connect a PayPal account to Xero. From the Settings menu, you want to go ahead and select General Settings. And then we're going to scroll down till we get to the Connect section here. And Payment Services is the last item here. So click on Payment Services. And to add a new payment service, you want to click this plus Add Payment Service button here. And then from the drop-down, you will see a list of payment services that you can connect to Xero. So we'll go ahead and select PayPal. Please note that depending on which payment service you have selected, the next few steps will vary. If you have an existing payment account with one of the services that's listed, be sure to have the user ID and password that you use to access that account handy so that you can just log in instead of creating a new account. In this next screen, we're going to enter the PayPal account details. This first field actually is how you'd like the name of the account to appear in Xero. So typically you're going to set up an account for your PayPal activity. So we'll call that PayPal. And the next field is your PayPal email address. If you have an existing PayPal account, enter the email address that you use for that account. Otherwise, enter the email address that you would like to use to set up a new PayPal account. Payment account. In this field, you want to select the account where the money will be deposited. Typically, that will either be your PayPal account, or if you have it set up to go to a bank account like your business checking, then you want to select that. So we'll go ahead and select PayPal account here. Automate fees. You want to go ahead and select this option if you would like for Xero to automatically create the spend money transaction to go ahead and record the fees for each PayPal transaction. And I do recommend that you do that. So we'll leave that check mark there. And then finally, where do you want the PayPal fees to be recorded? So that should definitely be a separate account from your PayPal account where your money will be showing up from your customers. So for here, you typically should go ahead and set up a PayPal fees account on your chart of accounts. Once you've made all your selections, go ahead and click the Save button. Please note that you may receive an email from PayPal, which will require you to confirm that you have set up a new PayPal account and/or connected a PayPal account to Xero. In order for you to accept payments, you must respond to that confirmation email. After you have successfully connected a payment service to Xero, you are ready to send your customers invoices that they can pay online. In the How to Invoice a Customer lesson, we showed you how to create and send invoices to your customers via email. You can click here to access this lesson. Now that we have added a payment service to Xero, the Pay Now button will appear on each customer's invoice that you send via email. Let's go ahead and take a look at the steps that your customer will follow to make a payment online. Your customer will receive an email similar to this one that will have a link to their invoice that they simply just need to click on that link. And notice the Pay Now button that I mentioned here. So they can click that button and they will be able to follow the steps to make their payment online. Let's go ahead and do that. So in this next screen, your customer, if they have a PayPal account, they can simply enter their user ID and password into these fields and then click login to go ahead and make the payment from their PayPal account. If your customer does not have an existing PayPal account, or if they prefer not to pay with their PayPal account, they can simply enter their debit or credit card information by clicking this button here. If your customer does not have an existing PayPal account, but they would like one, they can actually set up an account by entering their email address and password in these fields as well here. Once your customer has successfully made their payment, they will receive a notification. Behind the scenes, Xero will mark the invoice as paid in your system and reduce your accounts receivable balance by the amount paid. Your customer also has the option to save the invoice. They can save it as a PDF file, as a CSV file, or they can save it directly to Xero if they are also a Xero user. That wraps up the lesson on how to accept online payments from customers in Xero. To access our full Xero course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. If you have feedback about this course or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.